For the days when the nations shall beat their swords into plowshares and their spears into pruning hooks. Nations shall not lift up sword against nation, neither shall they learn war anymore. Let us walk in the light of the Lord.
The wolf shall live with the lamb, the leopard shall lie down with the kid. The calf and the lion and the fatling together, and a little child shall lead them. The wilderness and the dry land shall be glad. The desert shall rejoice and blossom. Like the rose, it shall blossom abundantly, and rejoice with joy and singing.
The Lord will give you a sign. Look, the young woman is with child, and shall bear a son, and shall name him Emmanuel. God is with us.
The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who lived in a land of deep darkness, on them light has shined. Let us walk in the light of the Lord.
Thank you. welcome our viewers from around the world. I had to say that. Wolf Blitzer gets to say it every night, so I thought it could be possible we could have viewers from around the world, right? So welcome everybody, and thanks so much for that beautiful music. I was saying to Kathy, my wife, today, it didn't really feel like Christmas Eve for some reason today, but with the beautiful music this evening, that was just wonderful. Thanks so much. Are you happy? From the church, this is recognition of all that you've done since March. Don't mess up the rest of this evening or we take the flowers back.
Can we set them right here?
Thank you so much. And I do want to thank the congregation for the continued generosity that the church members have had throughout this year. And despite the inability to come and worship, your efforts in mission and serving the poor and continuing to give for this church has been tremendous. And really want to thank you so much for that generosity that you have continued to show. All right, where was I? Oh, yes. A child has been born for us, a son given to us, and authority rests upon his shoulder, and he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Friends in Christ, in this Christmas season, we delight to hear again the message of the angels to go to Bethlehem and see the Son of God lying in a manger. Let us therefore open the Holy Scriptures and read the story of the loving purpose of God. The glorious redemption brought to us by this holy child. And let us make this place glad with carols of praise. Let us pray together. O wisdom coming forth from the mouth of the Most High, pervading and permeating all creation. You order all things with strength and gentleness. Come now and teach us the way to salvation. Come, Lord Jesus. O Adonai, ruler of the house of Israel, you appeared in the burning bush to Moses and gave him the law on Sinai. Come with outstretched arm to save us. Come, Lord Jesus. O root of Jesse, rising as a sign for all the people. Before you, earthly rulers will keep silent, and nations give you honor. Come quickly to deliver us. Come, Lord Jesus. O King of David, scepter over the house of Israel, you open and no one can close. You close and no one can open. Come to set free the prisoners who live in darkness and the shadow of death. Come, Lord Jesus. O radiant dawn, splendor of eternal light, Son of justice, come shine on those who live in darkness. Come, Lord Jesus. O ruler of the nations, monarch for whom the people long, you are the cornerstone uniting all humanity. Come, save us all, whom you formed out of clay. Come, Lord Jesus. O Emmanuel, our sovereign and lawgiver, desire of the nations and Savior of all, come and save us, O Lord our God. God of grace, ever faithful to your promise, the earth rejoices in hope of the Savior's coming and looks forward with longing to his return. Prepare our hearts to receive him when he comes, even now, for he is Lord forever and ever. Amen.
Stars of
Kim, thanks so much. That's awesome. What a fantastic voice and song that was. And we are so thankful that Christina has been able to sing a lot of the hymns for us on our behalf. And makes me want to sing them more if that's the way you're supposed to do it. That's not the way I do it. Before we begin with the readings, I just wanted to share a thought or two with you. I think we have a new phrase this year, stay healthy, stay safe. Have you heard that phrase before? I've been using that. I don't think we had that phrase before the pandemic, did we? We didn't greet one another by saying stay safe. But you know, now we do, right? And we know exactly what that means. Stay safe. This past year has made it clear that there's nothing in this world that we can put our ultimate trust in for our safety and security. And because of that, it's been the perfect storm for spiritual awakening. The ultimate reality is there is only God, and only God is worthy of our faith and our trust, and nothing else. But we in this body, being the physical manifestations of our soul, so often put our trust in money, or wealth, or institutions, or governments, or relationships. And we oftentimes put far too much faith and hope in our temporary physical life as well. And this is all a mistake setting us up for suffering and fear. I didn't think we would have to worry about staying safe a year ago. Most of us, you know, went through our daily living, we never really thought about fearing our safety, did we? I mean, we could go through life. I guess if you bought tickets in the upper deck at an Eagles game, you might worry about your safety, maybe then. When I was traveling to see Danny's lacrosse games on the Beltway of Baltimore, I was worried about my safety on the Baltimore Beltway. But by and large, you don't worry about your safety too much. But that all changed, didn't it? Just going to the grocery store can give us a panic attack because we fear for our safety, fear for our lives. But we should not get too attached to the idea that this physical body, this life, is who we are. It is only the current dwelling place of our soul. St. Paul calls it a tent. It's just a temporary dwelling place, this life, this body. That's why Jesus says, take up your cross. It's become aware that we are temporary beings in this body, in this life. Only God in Christ can save us from this trap of this delusion that we put our faith in the things of this world for our safety and security. When we completely trust or have faith in God, only then do we begin to open up spiritually to the joy and peace that transcends this world and is the source of our contentment and well-being. Only when we completely trust in God can we fully enjoy the present moment. We let go of clinging to things in this world for our security and safety. You know, Jesus put it this way, don't store up for yourselves treasures on earth. Rather, store up for yourselves treasures in heaven. When we fully trust God, no matter what is happening around us, when we have complete faith in God, we have faith in life in general. and faith and trust in God's universe. And then we can begin living life with joy and peace, even in the midst of a pandemic. We can calmly watch the passing by of all of life's chaotic disruptions. Our circumstances are ever evolving and changing. The future is uncertain, but we know that we are safe and secure with God, always and forever. And that is where we need to put in our trust and our faith in God. This is the message of Christmas, demonstrated perfectly in the Christ child, Emmanuel, which means God with us. Know that you are safe and secure in God's hands. And you always will be. And you always have been. Come hell or high water. The only question remains is, will you wake up to this reality? Or will you continue living in fear? The choice is up to you and I. Now let's hear the words of the Christmas story as it appears in Luke's Gospel, chapter 2, verses 1 to 7. In those days, Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken of the entire Roman world. This was the first census that took place while Quirinius was governor of Syria. And everyone went to his own town to register. So Joseph also went up from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house and line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him and was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in clothes and placed him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. And there were shepherds living out in the field nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shown around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news of great joy that will be for all the people. Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is Christ the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in clothes and lying in a manger." Suddenly a great company of the heavenly host appeared with the angel praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to men on whom his favor rests." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about." So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby who was lying in the manger. When they had seen him, they spread the word concerning what had been told them about this child. And all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds said to them. But Mary treasured up all these things and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things that they had heard and seen, which were just as they had been told.
Thank you.
come now to the Lord's table, and this sacrament is a sign of many things. It is a sign of Christ's presence within us. We eat the bread and we drink the cup, symbolizing that Christ's Spirit is inside of us. It's also a symbol of our oneness in the mystical body of Christ, that all those past, present, and future are all one in Christ and always will be. And so let's humbly come to this table and join together in this great feast that Christ has prepared for us. Let's pray together. It is truly right and our greatest joy to praise you, O holy God, creator and ruler of the universe. In the fullness of time, you sent your only Son, Jesus Christ, to be our Savior. In him, your word, dwelling with you from all eternity, became flesh and dwelt among us, full of grace and truth, and we beheld your glory. Let us pray for the needs of the whole world, for peace and justice on earth, for the unity and mission of the church for which Christ died, for the lives lost during the pandemic, and for the fearless compassion of all those who cared for them until the end. Let us remember in his name the poor and the helpless, the cold, the hungry, the oppressed, the sick, and those who mourn. And finally, let us remember before God that multitude which no one can number, whose hope is in the Word made flesh, and with whom in Jesus we are one forevermore. Especially we thank thee for those dear to us who have once shared our Christmas joy and now rejoice with thy saints in life. Keep us evermore in this communion and fellowship until we also receive the end of our faith, even life eternal. And let us pray in the words which Christ himself taught us, saying, Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. Jesus took these everyday elements and set them apart for this holy use. And when he was with the disciples in the upper room, he took bread, and after giving thanks, he broke it, and he said, This is my body, given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. And in the same manner, he took the cup, and after pouring it out, he said, This is a new covenant shed in my blood for the forgiveness of sins. As often as you drink it, do this in remembrance of me. So just be careful when you take the first tab off, to take the wafer out. And let us partake of the bread of life which has come down from heaven for us. And then be careful as you take the second tab off, the cup of salvation poured out for us. And then please dispose of this when you leave. I believe there's containers as you exit. Thank you. Eternal God, we give you thanks for this holy mystery in which you have given yourself to us. Grant that we may go into the world in the strength of your Spirit to give ourselves for others. In the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. We can just remain seated for silent night. It's great to see you all. As you exit, please return the panel, unless you're fascinated with the mind change. It's flickering. Did you see that? Amazing. Please, in all seriousness, please watch your spacing as we leave. I mean, we are in the midst of a surge, and we don't want anybody to get sick. So please be careful as you exit, and thank you for being here, and have a Merry Christmas and Happy New Year, everyone. May the love of God the Father, the grace of our Lord Jesus, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you today and forevermore. Amen.